Here's the video explaining what's wrong with the two envelope fallacy. I read a lot of different solutions from you guys, but this is the one that's most satisfying for me. Now again, we have two envelopes, and for concreteness, we'll say one has $1 and the other two. I pick an envelope, but I don't open it. Now remember, the fallacy went like this. My envelope has some unknown amount x, but the other envelope has either 2x or half x, each with an equal probability. So in expectation, the other envelope has x plus a quarter x in it, which is more than x, and so I should swap. Now here's my solution. Let's think of it in terms of actual money assigned, and then it will be super obvious what's wrong. Say that, unknown to me, my envelope contains $1, and so x is $1. Then what does the other contain? It's 2, right? But my previous calculation was trying to say it's either half a dollar or $2. And similarly, if my x had been actually $2, then the other is $1 and never $4. So claiming that the other envelope contains either 2x or half x is wrong. What that's saying is, regardless of x, this is true about the other envelope's value. But what we can see from the two cases is, this is clearly not true for any value of x. How do you do this correctly then? You don't know which of the two cases you're actually in, and so what you should do is average over the amount in the other envelope in each of those cases. That gives you a value of 1.5 for the expectation value, halfway between the two possible values. More formally, the expectation value of the second envelope is the probability that your x is 1, times the amount in the other envelope if that is the case, plus the probability your x is 2, times the amount in the other envelope if that's the case. Since the expectation value is exactly what you'd expect now, you shouldn't bother swapping. Thank you for all your comments about this fallacy. Lots of you saw what the problem was, but what I also really, really liked is that even when many of you couldn't figure it out, you still commented with some ideas you had about it and some hunches. That's the point of all these puzzle videos I make. It's to get you thinking. Whether you get the answer or not is irrelevant.